Hey, what's up, everybody? It is Chris Alexiak here, product research engineer at NVIDIA, and today I'm excited to talk to you about a single NIM container that can run a broad range of models, right? So you may have heard of different inference backends like TensorRT-LLM, vLLM, SGLang, right? All different ways that we can do inference with these models. This is a single NIM container to bind them all. The idea is that you don't have to worry about what backend is supported by what model, et cetera, et cetera. This NIM is going to help you launch those models with relative ease. So how do we actually use the thing? Well, it's pretty straightforward. Basically, we're going to export our NIM image, which is going to be LLM NIM. Once we've done that, we're going to go ahead and export our Hugging Face token. This is because we may want to use like a gated model, right? So we first request access on Hugging Face, and then we would download it in our local environment. Once we've done that, we have one last step, which is going to be to create this NIM cache in our present working directory. And what that does is it allows a place where the model's weights can live so that if we want to launch these NIMs in the future, we don't have to like re-download them each and every time. I've already gone ahead and done this, so we're going to see that error, but that's totally fine. Once we've done those three steps, right? So we exported the NIM image, we exported the Hugging Face token, and then we made sure that we had the NIM cache, we're actually good to go. You're gonna see this Docker command. Mine's gonna look a little bit different than yours, right? But the idea is basically, we're gonna run this on the third GPU of our environment. We're gonna have the shared memory size of 16 gigabytes. We're gonna do some kind of Docker bookkeeping here, again, pointing to this NIM cache, which we've created, right, to store those weights. Make sure we pass in our Hugging Face token. In this case, because we're using one GPU, we're just gonna set tensor parallel size to one. And then we're gonna point to the actual model name. So we're gonna be using CodeStroll22B V0.1 for this. And then we're gonna expose the correct port and then make sure we're pointing to our NIM image. That's all we have to do to get started with this NIM for LLMs that, again, is going to dynamically select available backends. So I'm going to let this thing load up, and then I'm going to come back after it's loaded, and we'll show you how long it took, and then we'll go from there. All right, we're back. As you can see, this thing is up and running. And again, we didn't have to do anything other than that Docker command. And you'll notice that it didn't take very long at all. So we're just going to scroll up here to see, just how long it took. It was 18 seconds to actually load that graph. And that is really about it. So everything else that, happened, 2.6 seconds, 6 seconds for loading the model. These things happen very quickly once we have the weights downloaded. Obviously, if you're downloading the weights, it's going to take a little bit extra time. The next thing we're going to look at is, how can we determine what backends are available to run our model? So let's go ahead and jump into those commands now. All right, so now what we want to do is we actually want to see, what profiles are available for, let's say, llama 3.1 AP instruct, right? So this is the same style of Docker command. We're pointing to the specific GPU we want. We're exposing the ports we want. But we've made an important change, which is that we're including this list model profiles configuration as well as pointing to that model. So what this is going to do when we run it is it's actually going to use the LLM NIM container, right, to figure out what backends are available so that we can then decide which we want to use depending on, a number of different factors that we may like or dislike about different inference backends. So you'll see that this is going through the same process as what we saw before. The only difference is that instead of spinning up the LLM NIM at the end of the day, it's just going to tell us these profiles. So you'll see that we have a vLLM profile, a TensorRT LLM profile, an SGLang profile, as well as LoRa profiles for each of the available engines. So this is one way we can check to see if we have available engines. Let's look at an example that has fewer available engines, which is going to be this Lava 3, Lava Next 8B. Again, it's the same Docker command, right? Nothing's changed. We're giving this the same style command. We're just using this list model profiles and then pointing to the model that we care to find the profiles of. It's going to go through the same process as we just saw, of course, and what it's going to tell us at the end is what backends are available. You'll notice here that this is aware of what GPU or hardware you have, right? So it knows that I've got an H100 80 gigabyte. And then you can see here as well that we only have an SGLang, you know, compatible engine. So when we spin up this NIM, it's going to go ahead and it's going to make sure that it's selected that, you know, specific backend that is compatible. What we're going to do now is explore, you know, what if we had like an AWQ quantized model like you see here. So this is the Qwen 2.514B instruct with that AWQ, you know, quantization. Well, again, because this NIM is able to determine which backend to leverage, when we go to spin this model up, we're actually going to select a compatible backend with this checkpoint. And that's the whole idea, right? Is that it's just made to make things a little bit easier. Make sure that you've got the correct backend selected when you go to set things up. We're going to go ahead and let this thing load and come back when it's finished. And we come back and see this NIM for LLMs is now ready to start doing sweet, sweet inference. That's it for this particular video. You know, please try out this LLM NIM container. It just simplifies things a lot. Thanks so much for watching. Again, I've been Chris, and have a great rest of your day.